mapayapa.
Mahalin natin ang Pilipinas, mahalin natin ang Pilipinas, mahalin natin ang Pilipinas, ikintal mo, huwag nang magtampo. Kapakanan ng bayan ang unahin mo.
Magkaisa na tayo, di man magkasundo. At huwag ka nang magalit pa, itigil ang gulo. Bayan ay nagdurugo, kapwang Pilipino. Kung tayo din sa dulo ang hindi magkasundo,
mahalin natin ang Pilipinas, mahalin natin ang Pilipinas, mahalin
natin ang Pilipinas, mahalin natin ang Pilipinas, mahalin natin ang Pilipinas, ikintal mo,
huwag na magtampo.
Bahon, edukasyon, bunga ng pagkakaisa, pagulat ng bayan.
Kapwa'y huwag mo itin, dahil sa galit mo. Ibig mo bang sabihin ay wala siyang talino? Sana tayo'y magkasundo bilang Pilipino. Gawin nating layunin na magkaisa tayo.
Mahalin natin ang Pilipinas, mahalin natin ang Pilipinas, mahalin
unahin mo.
Philippines, President Rodrigo Roa Duterte. May we request everyone to please settle down and proceed to your assigned seats. Our program will start in a short while. Once again, may we request everyone to please settle down and proceed to your assigned seats. Our program will start in a short while. Once again, we request everyone to please settle down. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, please settle down. Again, please settle down. Please settle down, ladies and gentlemen. Again, everyone, please settle down. We are going to begin the program. Good afternoon, Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the inauguration of the 15th Vice President of the Republic of the Philippines. Good afternoon, Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the inauguration of the 15th Vice President of the Republic of the Philippines. To formally start the program, please rise for the singing of the Philippine National Anthem and the Tayo'y Dabawenyo and for the Ecumenical Prayer.
Dakol kapag pasalamat na ito, pagkuntaan tungod na kay kaon kaupiya, si kay kaon kamig-imot langit, way tano, way langon na kautatawan kahit kalibutan. Kunt- Pasalamatan noy magbabayo. Kakoy kon pagbuhay ka kaupianan way kaalam to kanami no. Vice President elect Honorable Sara Duterte. Dakon kahalaan to kanami in tribo. Kristiyano, Muslim way malumahad ka ito tibok Davao. Kakanamin pag-ampo manama. Waro lain og salihan noy bulihino si kandin bahit katuanan kaalam giyahino ka kandin no pagkinabuhi ayaw o ka panalanginan kalangon no maotaw puunta Luzon Visayas way Mindanao. Salamat magbabayo bisan to langon pamilya Duterte kahit Davao City panalanginin no buhay no malayat na umol way protection matag sa aldo manama. Langon igsalig ko, do tangaran na Jesus na amoy na manama. Salamat.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Faqala rabbukum udu'ani astajib lakum. Amin ya rabbal alamin. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Arrahmanirrahim. Maliki yawmiddin. Iyaka na'budu, iyaka nasta'inu hadina siratal mustaqim. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. نشكر الله العظيم وميور إنداي سارة دوترتي كارفيو على ما قدمت لنا في داباو سيتي من الخيرات الكثيرة طول مدتها في عمدة داباو سيتي مع سكان مدينة داباو من المعاملات الإنسانية مليئة بالمحبة والوداد بين أتباعها سواء أكان مسلما من بنسى مورو المتواجدين بالمدينة أو كريستيان أو لومد على حد سواء ونسأل الله لها التوفيق والنجاح لمن سبيها الجديد بايس بريسيدنت على مستوى الفلبين من دلو بسياس لوزون أن تقوم الواجب لاستمرار الأمن والسلام بين شعب وطننا الفلبين لأجل التقدم والازدهار في بلدنا الحبيب الفلبين. ولا ننسى أن ندعو الله تعالى لإخوانهما التوفيق والسداد أمثال كونغرسمان باولو دوترتي وميور باستي دوترتي النجاح في أعمالهما وأن يسدد خطاهما برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وأيضا لا ننسى أن نسأل الله العظيم أن يحفظ لنا حبيبنا الغالي تاتاي نانغ فيليبيناس فيرديناند بريسيدنت ديكونغ رودريغو دوتارتي على ما قدمه من الأعمال الجليلة في تحسين أوضاع بلدنا الحبيب الفلبين ويطول عمره برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين والحمد لله آمين يا رب العالمين.
Paginoon po namin Diyos, Ama naming makapangyarihan sa lahat, buong puso po kaming nagpapasalamat sa namamalagi naming buhay at lakas maging ng liwanag ng aming kaisipan. Salamat din po sa iyo, matagumpay at mapayapang naisagawa ang halalan sa aming bayan. At ngayon, nakatakdang manumpa ang inihalal na pangalawang pangulo ng aming bayan. Sana po ito ang lagi nilang maalala. Ito nawa ang maging gabay nila sa pagtupad ng kanilang mga pananagutan para sa ikabubuti ng aming bayan. Panginoong Hesukristo, pakipamagitan mo po kaming lagi sa Ama para mapatawad din ang aming mga pagkakasala. Dinggin ang aming mga panalangin na isa po rito ang pagkakaisa ng lahat ng mamamayang Pilipino para sa kapakanan ng aming minamahal na bayan. Umaasa rin po kami, Ama, patuloy mong gagabayan ang mga namimiluno sa aming bayan, hindi lamang upang pantay-pantay na maipatupad ang batas at katarungan, kundi makapamalagi rin ang malaya na paglilingkod at pagsamba sa iyong pangalan. Umaasa po kami narinig mo't ipinagkaloob ang aming mga padalangin sapagkat hinihiling po namin ang lahat sa pangalan po ng aming Panginoong Hesukristo. Amen.
In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, Amen. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this great assembly of our beloved and chosen people, for every seat and place that has been filled, and those who witness far and wide in this historical event to join and celebrate this momentous gathering. Its mind and hearts are filled with awe and wonder, especially here in our beloved city of Davao. Almighty and loving Father, you will that men and women be chosen to govern your people in your name. They are chosen to serve our country in leadership roles. We lift up the Vice President-elect, Her Excellency Sara Duterte-Carpio. Grant, O Lord, that she be given the strength, courage, and protection to dedicate her whole life to public service. May the commitment of our beloved Inday Sara Mayor to serve the Filipino people be guided always with love and enthusiasm in your name. Give her peace and fulfillment when her work sometimes takes her away from her family. Heavenly Father, we pray that as she serves our country, guide and bless also her father, beloved Mayor, former President Rodrigo Rua Duterte. Bless her as a woman, wife, and a mother. Bless also all the Davaoinos and Mindanaoans. We ask you to be always near her in all her efforts to serve the Filipino people with love, compassion, efficiency, and fairness. And when the call of justice is challenged, guide her with wisdom and integrity that your kingdom may reign in our beloved country. Through the power of the Holy Spirit, let her decisions and works redound to your honor and glory. Bless all her decisions. Bestow on her the wisdom and the strength, and surround her with advisors whose heartbeats beat for the good, if not for the best, and for the good of our country. Sustain her to fulfill what she believes and thinks for the good of every Filipino people. May Jesus our Lord, the source of all holiness and goodness, fill her heart with peace and love as she strives to serve with all the faculty and wisdom you provide in her office at the second highest place of service to our country. May the mantle of the Blessed Virgin Mary and her example of Magnificat be her guiding light. We pray that unite us all, allow your love to heal and act as one. You all this we pray and ask in the name of Jesus, our Lord. Mayor Inday, padayon sa pagkaisog, padayon sa pagkamatinabangon, padayon sa pagkabuutan. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Please be seated. At this point, let us welcome Mr. Andrew E. and Mr. Niel de Mesa for an intermission number.
Bit-bit ko ang sambayan ng Pilipino, yung katuwaan nila sa puso nila. Kaya congratulations po, Madam Inday Sara. Congratulations po. Davao, pahingi ng ingay! Davao, pahingi ng ingay! Davao, pahingi ng ingay! Parang ito ang pinakamaingay ah. Parang ito. Siya'y isang simpleng tao, aking napatunayan. Idolo ng marami at hindi ng kaibigan. Sa ay kasama ko sa buong kapuluan. Umikot kami at siya'y aking sinamahan. At lalo na ngayon, naging VP ka na. Humanga ako sa isang Inday Sara. Andrew Inday Sara, side by side. Pinoto ka ng sambayanan ng landslide. VP si Inday Sara! Everybody, sabay-sabay! VP na si Inday Sara, mag-ingay! VP na si Inday Sara, VP na si Inday Sara, VP na si Inday Sara, mag-ingay! VP na si Inday Sara, mag-ingay! VP na si Inday Sara, mag-ingay! Sara mag-ingay. Oh, bagong Pilipina. Oh, may prinsipyo ba isa? Oh, kaibigan nyo, kaibigan ko, siya si Inday Sara. Oh, bagong Pilipina. Come on, may prinsipyo ba isa? Oh, kaibigan nyo, kaibigan ko, siya si Inday Sara. Pag sinabi kong pangalan, sabihin apelyido, okay? Okay? Oh, Inday Sara! Oh, Inday Sara! Come on, Inday Sara! Oh, Inday Sara! Come on, Inday Sara! Ang aming bagong vice presidente! Break it down! Congratulations po, Madam Inday Sara Duterte. Ma'am, may boses na po ako. Pwede na po tayong mag-campaign ulit. Maraming po salamat! God bless Pilipinas! Thank you!
Mga kababayan, ang susunod na Vice Presidente ng Republika ng Pilipinas, Inday Sara Duterte! Umapagaspas sa hangin, dala-dala rin ng alon. Lilipad tayo, ipagpapatuloy ang pagbabago. Itataguyod ang bawat Pilipino sa kanyang talino. Aahon tayo, lilipad na ang agila. Magtatanggol, magmamahal sa ating bansa. Lilipad na ang agila. At bagong araw at pag-asa kanyang dala. Sa paglipad sa taglay niyang lakas, hindi tayo matitipad. Sa kanyang puso ay titibay tayo. Tatatag-tataas, lilipad tayo. Bagong araw at pag-asa kanyang dala sa kanyang mga bakbak. Kasama tayo sa paglipad sa taglay niyang lakas. Hindi tayo matitipad. Sa kanyang puso ay titibay tayo. Tatatag-tataas, lilipad tayo.
Thank you, Mr. Andrew E. and Mr. Niel de Mesa. And now for the administration of oath of office to Vice President-elect Sara Zimmerman Duterte, may we call on Supreme Court Associate Justice Ramon Paul Hernando. May we request on stage President Rodrigo Roa Duterte. And Mrs. Elizabeth Zimmerman Duterte to witness the oath-taking. At this point, we now call Vice President-elect Sara Zimmerman Duterte for the administration of oath of office.
Good afternoon, Madam Vice President-elect. You will be taking your oath pursuant to Section 5, Article 7 of the Constitution as the duly elected Vice President of the Philippines. Please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I,
Sara Zimmerman Duterte,
do solemnly swear
That I will faithfully and conscientiously fulfill
my duties as Vice President of the Philippines. Preserve and defend its Constitution. Execute its laws. Do justice to every man. And consecrate myself. To the service of the nation. So help me God. Congratulations and all the best, Madam Vice President.
Thank you.
gentlemen, the 15th Vice President of the Republic of the Philippines, Vice President-elect Sara Zimmerman Duterte.
Assalamualaikum to our foreign guests, sa aking mga kababayan. Magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat. Maayong hapon sa inyong tanan. One of the most important lessons I have learned as I navigate life, and the same thing that I believe we should ponder upon as a one country united in our determination to overcome our difficulties and achieve our aspirations is that we should commit to the to heart the priorities of God, country, and family. My life is a testament to the power of a God whom we know by many names. My younger self was consumed by a dream to become a doctor. I pursued a pathway that I thought could help me realize that dream. But I was directed toward another way. And now I am a lawyer. When I committed myself to governance and public service, I was also determined to finish 3 consecutive terms as mayor. That will not happen anymore. I am now the vice president-elect. The voice of 32.2 million Filipinos was loud and clear. With the message to serve our motherland. And this message has been reiterated in my oath to consecrate myself to the service of the nation. There is a God whose will transcends the desires of our hearts, one whose will directs us to the way that we might not have imagined, but a way that consecrates ourselves every day to help our fellow men overcome the difficulties they face in their lives, to change lives, to save lives. If you all take a moment to listen to the call to serve and decide to heed the call,
In the same way that many are already devoting their lives as hardworking farmers and fisherfolk that ensure that there is food on our tables, dedicated health workers who help the sick, brave soldiers who fight for our country, honest and fair entrepreneurs who support our economy, patient school teachers that guide our children. I believe the country will be heading towards a future of hope, security, strength, stability, and progress. Today, we celebrate the life and works of our national hero, Dr. Jose Rizal. May his memory light up the fire within us to become patriots. Rizal taught us that selflessness and sacrifice could change our country's fate and shape our children's future. The bravery of Rizal completes the fabric of our identity as Filipinos. Magkasama sana tayong bumangon bawat araw, kasabay ang nag-aalab na pangako sa ating mga puso na mahal natin at patuloy nating mamahalin ang Pilipinas hanggang tayo ay nabubuhay. Let us show our love for our country by taking care of our families and communities despite the unending challenges that come their way. Today is Father's Day. This is a time for families. But you are here with me. Daghang salamat sa inyong pagtambong ug pagkuyog kanako niining adlawa. Happy Father's Day to all the fathers who make sure that another person is given the best of everything. Today, our children are facing a very complex future, one that is rife with conflict and uncertainties. Some of these challenges include the winding cycle of poverty, the trauma of broken families, the lifelong baggage because of irresponsible and bad parenting, the abandonment issues due to an absentee parent, the anguish of gender confusion and discrimination, the destruction brought about by drugs, the lure of easy money in criminality, cases of HIV and other sexually transmitted diseases, the failure to identify and speak up against different kinds of abuses, the life-altering effects of teenage pregnancy, the detrimental effects of illiteracy, the emotional injury of bullying, unstable mental wellness, recruitment to support terrorism, misinformation in the internet. The list could be endless. A strong, loving, happy family sets down all the basic foundations essential in the development and growth of a child. At home, parents have the duty to teach children the values of integrity, discipline, respect, and compassion for others. And we should never forget that it is the duty of each Filipino family to emphasize that education begins at home. Atong isilsil sa ilang alimpatakan na ang maayong pamatasan, edukasyon, ug pagpaningkamot maoy magdala kanila palayo sa kinabuhi nga puno og kalisod, padulong sa maayong kinabuhi nga ilang ginahandom. We cannot afford to squander the future of our children. The days ahead may be full of challenges that call for us to be more united as a nation. But let me reiterate this. We can never go wrong if we are a people dedicated to honoring the will of God, to serving our country and our fellow men, and protecting the integrity of our families and the future of our children. Ako po si Inday Sara, a proud Davaoenia, very proud, a proud Mindanaon. Hindi ako ang pinakamagaling o pinakamatalinong tao sa Pilipinas at sa mundo. Ngunit, walang makakatalo sa tibay ng puso ko bilang isang Pilipino. Mabuhay ang Pilipinas! Dagang salamat.
Thank you very much, Vice President-elect Sara Zimmerman Duterte, for your message. We will now have the photo opportunity with Vice President-elect Sara Zimmerman Duterte. May we request President Rodrigo Roa Duterte, Mrs. Elizabeth Zimmerman Duterte, and Associate Justice Ramon Paul Hernando to join the Vice President-elect. For the second batch, may we call former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo to join on stage. Thank you, Associate Justice Hernando and former President Arroyo. And for the third batch, the Vice President-elect with her parents, President Rodrigo Roa Duterte, and Mrs. Elizabeth Zimmerman Duterte. For the fourth batch, may we call on stage the Duterte, Zimmerman, and Carpio family members to join the Vice President-elect and her parents. Thank you, Mr. President, Mrs. Zimmerman Duterte and family. At this point, the Vice President-elect will be joined by her spouse, Attorney Manasses Carpio, and their children, Micaela Maria, Mateo Lucas, and Marco Digong. Attorney Carpio and children. The Vice President-elect will be joined by President-elect Ferdinand R. Marcos Jr., his spouse, Attorney Liza Araneta Marcos, Ilocos Norte District 1 Representative-elect Sandro Marcos, and Senator Aimee Marcos. Thank you. Thank you, President-elect Bongbong Marcos and family. Ladies and gentlemen, that ends the inaugural ceremony. Once again, thank you, Mayor President Rodrigo Roa Duterte, for your presence in this momentous event. Thank you and congratulations, Vice President-elect Sara Zimmerman Duterte. And to all of you, daghang salamat! To those who wish to have a photo with Vice President-elect Sara Zimmerman Duterte, kindly proceed to the Quezon Park. Our ushers will guide you. Again, to those who wish to have a photo with Vice President-elect Sara Zimmerman Duterte, kindly proceed to the Quezon Park. Our ushers will guide you. Once again, thank you and good evening.